Good morning. In today's live stream, we are going to be going over how to import a budget in Sage Intacct Construction. So first, I'm going to navigate over to the area where a bunch of templates are found for importing different types of data. Okay, so you can see there's many things you can import, and there's templates that are provided for those types of imports. So we're going to scroll down here and look at the budgets area. So you can see that here. And we're going to click on the template button here. Okay. So it's going to give us an Excel file. And in the Excel file, what it does, as you can see, it gives you columns, column headers that go with the field in Intacct. It also gives you the requirements, different types of lengths, you know, a whole bunch, you can read them, but a whole bunch of different informational things in here so you can get this formatted correctly. So we're going to put some sample data in here, and then we're going to upload this template into Intacct so you can see just kind of how simple it is. So I'm going to get my screen situated here. So I'm going to throw this over here for a second on Intacct so I can see the account numbers that we can use. So I'm going to go over here. Actually, I'll show Intacct right here. I'm going to go over here and I'm going to look at the budget area and let's see if we have any budgets set up yet. Okay, so let's go over here to the budgets repository. So this will be like your, you know, where you would start a budget. So we've got some already created. Okay, so I'm going to open this up. And the budget ID is standard budget. Okay, so that's what I was looking for there. Okay, so you'll want to come in here and create the budget in the budget repository and name it, give it a name, and then you can start using the budget on this template. Okay, the standard budget. All right, so let's throw this over here for a second. So I'm going to look in my chart of accounts. And let's go. To more of like the income statement area. Start putting in some information here. So 4010, let's do a chunk of data here. And now if I have departments, locations, or project customers, vendors, any of this information, if I want to bring that in a detail level, I could. For our sample data, we're going to just bring in the location. Okay, and the location also is your entity list up here. So I'm going to use TCG for my location that I'm working with here. And I'm going to skip this very detailed level of information. Okay. Now, and so let's hide this because we don't want to see all of that. Okay. Budgetable period one. So this is going to be your different periods you have set up in Sage Intacct. Okay. So they give you examples here. So for example, month ended August 2014. So this is where we would enter in the budget values for, you know, if it's monthly totals, if it's an annual. So here's the amounts where we would, here's where we would enter in the amounts for the different periods. Okay. So I'm going to go back into my Intacct here. Throw this on the other side for a second. And I'll bring it back over when I show you what I'm going to do here. Okay, so let's just put some amounts in here. And let's work with, let's do three periods for now. Let's do $1,000 each for that. Give it some variables in here. Okay. So another way you can do budgets as well, before I get this imported in, you can actually come into the budget and you can enter in through the budget details line items. So if you click here and you, we picked pick a different one, you can actually just add them in manually as well. Okay, so there is that option. Click show periods here, and then I can enter in my different amounts in my different months. Okay, so if I entered in, and some random numbers here. Okay, and you can also put notes next to them if you wanted to, but I'm going to leave them that way. I'm going to checkmark these. Okay, let's double check. We don't need anything else up here. So these, this is very detailed level again. So I'm just putting it to a location for the moment. Now I can use these as filters. So down below here, you can see, you know, it gives me quite a lot of periods. So you could put, you know, a filter on here and it'll only give you a certain range. So we're going to hit save up here. Okay, so now you can see the budget details for my standard budget. It created a row here, okay? So if I click, now you can see it's by account. So obviously you're not seeing all the lines I entered in month by month, right? So you can come in here and view it and see some more detail. There's also reporting you can do, you know, once you get it entered in to see your, you know, you could do start and end period. So I think I did September to December. Could do something like this. Let's just see what that gives us. So you can see now the line I entered in, the 40-40 account, and my monthly totals I put in for those 4 months. Okay. You can export it to Excel and do different things as well up here. Add it to your dashboard, you know, do other reporting on this, you know, if you want budget versus actual and such. Okay. All right. So let's go back here to the budget repository. So again, you start here, a budget repository. If you want to see or play with the budget, you click on budget details. You click add to add a account line. And then if you want to see, you know, month by month, that budget line. If you want to edit it, you can come back in here and do some more editing. Okay. Okay. So let me save this. I'm just going to scroll over here for a second and see if the template gave us any more periods, and it did not. Okay. So we're going to import these in, and then we're going to see, I'm going to show you, like, if you want to add more periods to here, if you want like a 12 month budget, you know, how you do that on this, this template here. Okay. Okay. Let's go back over here. And throw this over here for 1 second. Okay. So on the budget repository screen, again, you can see the import button right here. Okay. So we're going to hit the import button. I'm going to move that file to the other side here so you can see up the screen. Choose the file. The date format. Can you leave that there? You can leave that alone. And then this will email me the results once I hit the import button here. Oh, you need to save it as a CSV. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to go check the status, see what that came in, what the email results showed. So I'll pull that up here in a second. Just takes a minute to send it through. Okay, and the import was successful. So again, once the import occurs in your budget details here, it's going to appear just like this line item here, and it's going to list out your monthly, the periods and your by account. So I accidentally put this one as percent, but so let's look at that here. I can edit this. So right here, we want to make sure we pick them out. Sorry, I missed that that bullet a little bit ago. So let's fix that. Okay, so when you import it, it's going to come in just like this. So it's bringing it in at the moment, but when it's all done, it'll do the same function as this add button up here. Okay, so then you can run your reports here. So if we ran that for September to December. Again, you can see the detailed line items. Okay, so really nice functionality in here. If you come to this import data, I put this as a favorite. You can see a lot of different, quite a bit is in here to import, obviously including the budget, but if you star that, then you can easily find that in your favorites here. So if you wanted to, if you have multiple imports you do for budgets or anything, just hit the favorite button and it'll show up there. Okay. So if there's any questions, reach out to help@bangertinc.com and we can assist you. If there is, very specific, budget questions, or if you have a really detailed one, we can assist you with the template, or if you have general questions about budgets or anything in general, reach out to help@bangertinc.com. Thank you for your time today.